Hey, if you're looking to calculate the internal rate of return, the IRR, for your tech startup, maybe a potential investor's asked you what your expected IRR is for this investment, then you've come to the right place. We created a little calculator here in Excel, and I'm going to show you how to use this. It's a free calculator. I'll link to this in the description of the video below, so you can go grab that. And then give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel as well while you're there. So I'm going to walk you through how to use this. First of all, my name is Adam Hooksema. I'm the co-founder of ProjectionHub, and we've helped thousands of entrepreneurs create financial projections for potential investors and lenders. And one of the common questions we get is, hey, my investor asked me about what IRR I might be able to expect, and can you build that into the projection? So the way to do that, the first thing you're going to need to do is create a set of cash flow projections. So if you don't already have a set of cash flow projections, that's step number one. And we do have a library of 60 different financial projection templates that you can use to create your cash flow projections. And we'll link to that in the description of the video as well. Once you've created your cash flow projections for the first 5 years, then you're going to come into this tool here, and I'll show you how to fill it out. So let's say your investor is going to put in $1 million here. All right, so you're going to put in $1 million, and then that investor is going to be able to expect $500,000, $500,000 loss in the first year, $250,000 positive cash flow in second, and $500,000, $1 million, and then $2 million in year five in positive cash flow. Now, we also need to build in a little bit of information about the future growth rate assumptions, and then a discount rate. Now, discount rate is kind of a confusing term, and I'm not going to get into all of that right now. You can do some of your own Google research, but one way to think about what a discount rate should be is what's the minimum annual return that your investors expect. So I put in 15%, and we're going to assume that our company grows at a 12% cash flow growth rate in perpetuity. And based on all these inputs, we can click here and we'll be able to see that our internal rate of return is expected to be 134%. Now, I want to really highlight something here. If you were to just calculate your internal rate of return based on these numbers alone, now I'll just do a little trick here. So I'll show you that calculation here. This calculation in Excel, you do equals IRR, and then you copy the total cash flows that you want to use for the calculation, right? So I'm going to just do this again here below, but instead of including this terminal value here, I'm actually going to use, I'm gonna grab these cash flows, just these cash flows. And now you can see here, the IRR is only 27%. It goes up to 134% when you include this terminal value, future cash flows. Now, here's the tough thing about, you know, tech startups and why, in my opinion, using IRR for really for any sort of tech startup doesn't make a whole lot of sense, because so much of the value is in those future cash flows, way beyond what you can project in a five-year projection. You can see $74 million worth of cash flows are after the 5 years, right? These are the in perpetuity. But if you were to, if that investor asked you, you know, what's your IRR, and you only showed them based on your first 5 years of projections, and you don't take into consideration those future cash flows, the IRR that you're getting is only 27%. That's probably not what a venture capitalist or, you know, angel investor is going to be looking for. And so you have to kind of include the terminal value for to ever come up with an IRR that's going to make sense. So I wanted to just kind of talk through how we think about that. Now, a lot of times internal rate of return is used in real estate, because real estate projects, they're more predictable, right? You know, okay, rent's going to go up 5% a year, and we know the useful life of this building is such and such. And so you can really do that and get a more precise and reliable IRR. But nevertheless, sometimes you're a founder, you're a tech founder, and investor's going to ask you about an IRR, and you need to come up with something to show them. This is what you'd want to do. So again, you can grab this template for free in the link in the description of the video below, and give us a like and subscribe to our channel. We'd love to share more content with you like this. All right, thanks.